Hello friends and welcome back to Droom Discovery. Now this is the newest entrant into the Indian mid-size SUV market. It's called the Kia Seltos and it made its world debut in Delhi a few weeks back. This will be Kia's first offering for the Indian car market. The bookings are open and the pricing will be out on the 22nd of August. Now what you see here is the range topping GT line version, which is available with the 1.4 litre GDI turbo-petrol engine, both manual and automatic. The one we have is the 7-speed automatic, the 7-speed DCT or the dual clutch, which you can see right now over here, the 7-DCT dual clutch. The GT line does have a lot of differentiating factors as compared to the normal version, which you can see in the car right now. I'll also be talking about the key elements which make it very different, starting with these indicators which are positioned under the headlamps and do have a lot of slats to make it look very cool. The DRLs inside the assembly of the headlamps, and these DRLs which stretch all the way till the center of the grille. The headlamps themselves are LEDs, and you also get these ice cube LEDs fog lamps in the bumper. The GT line, by the way, also has differentiating factors like the red lip running over here, the GT line logo on the grille, and on the side this one gets larger 17 inch alloy wheels which have red calipers for the brakes and a red cap for the Kia logo. On the side you have the red inserts on the side doors, and at the back you again have GT line embossing the tag right over here. LEDs are all around, including at the back. You can see even the tail lights, they get the LED treatment. These are visible even in daytime, and of course the indicators, which do look quite cool. You also have a dual fake exhaust kind of a diffuser outlet at the back in the bumpers. Quite a nice effect there to increase the sporty quotient of the Seltos. So overall, I think in terms of the design, Kia has got it right. The body shell itself, the entire body shell, isn't very radically different. What makes it very good are these design elements, as I showed you, the alloy wheels, the contrasting roof, the DRLs, the LEDs. That really makes the Seltos stand out among the crowd of other midsize SUVs. In fact, this will be competing with the Creta, Harrier, Hector and Compass, and I think it's a job done very well. On the inside, we are in the automatic version right now. This one is not available in a proper top-end version. There are features missing. And you get all black interiors. The proper top end of the GT line in the manual has black and beige interiors. This one has all black interiors, but features are definitely missing. What is missing? Well, for starters, the manual top end has ventilated seats. The buttons are right here. This one doesn't have that. The manual top end also has a 360 degree view camera. This one only has a rear camera, which comes onto the screen when the car is in motion. And of course, you do not get powered driver's seat or a sunroof and so on. So features in the automatic are definitely missing, but you still get three screens. The first one is the infotainment system, the largest in the segment. The second is the driver info display, and the third is the heads up display unit right over there, which has the speed for the driver. This itself is known to offer very good output in terms of the sound quality, and has a lot of features, including the smart mood lighting, which you can play with once the car is in motion. It's when it started. You can also switch on and off the smart air again once the car is on, which is not right now. But the overall fit and finish of buttons, the quality levels are definitely very good in this Kia Seltos. At the back, you do have class leading leg room. Again, all black interiors. You have the AC vents right over there. The display for the smart air comes here. You have your fast charging outlet, an armrest, and the overall seat comfort and space is definitely very good. But the big question, how is the Seltos to drive? Well, that is what we'll be talking about in the next few minutes. So guys, for dynamics and for performance, stay tuned to the video. If you are into cars, you must have realized by now that the Seltos will be offered with three different engines and an automatic will be part of the package in all of them. On the drive, we had the chance to sample the 1.5 diesel and the 1.4 turbo petrol, and that is what we'll talk about now. Do note, all the engines in the Seltos will be BS6 ready. The 1.5 diesel is good for 115 PS of power and 250 Nm of torque. These figures are less than some of the rivals, but surprise, surprise, on the move, the Seltos diesel does not feel underpowered at all. In fact, the flat torque curve from as low as 1500 RPM to approximately 3000 RPM is what makes your city runs very effortless. Further, the NVH or the noise, vibration, harshness levels are well under control, and this is one area where Kia has done a lot of hard work. We drove the manual version only due to lack of time, and the gear shift quality was top notch. Next was the 1.4 GDI turbo petrol version that we drove and thankfully managed to experience both the manual and automatic models. With 140 PS of power on hand and almost same levels of torque as the diesel motor, were grinning moments part of the package? Well, given the price segment, definitely yes. And with a flat max torque curve that starts at 1500 RPM and extends all the way till 3200 RPM, city runs are a breeze. At slower speeds, you can potter around in a higher gear without any unwanted stress or drones from the engine. And though the stick shift is preferred by enthusiasts, the 7-speed DCT is a gem of a unit. We remember our drive in the Hector DCT and can safely say this one feels a generation ahead. The shifts are quick and the Seltos can be a hoot to drive both on city roads and open highways. No paddle shifters here, but you can take charge by flicking the gear lever to the right side. In terms of comfort, it is good news. But let us add that enthusiasts will be disappointed. Why? Well, Kia has worked hard to ensure the ride remains comfortable, and even the GT line variants with these 17-inch alloy wheels ensure you aren't tossed around. In fact, at times, with these 16-inch wheels, the ride seems plush without the rear moving all over the place. Body roll is limited too, but the steering is more family person oriented than for younger guns. Don't get us wrong here, Kia knows a majority of buyers seek comfort, and that is what the Seltos offers.